Hi, hello guys, good morning. This is Srinivasan. Today the topic we are going to discuss from same history unit number 8. Our topic is, it's a final session, our topic is developments leading to Quit India movement and towards freedom. Individual Satyagraha. In August 1940, Viceroy Lynn Lithgow made an offer in return for Congress support for the war effort. However, the offer of dominion status in an unspecified future was not acceptable to the Congress. However, it did not want to hamper the British during its struggle against the fascist forces of Germany and Italy. Hence, Gandhi declared limited satyagraha offered by a few individuals. The objective was to convey to the world that though India was opposed to Nazism, it did not enter the war voluntarily. Vinoba Bhave was the first to offer satyagraha on 17th October 1940. The satyagraha continued till the end of the year. During this period, more than 25,000 people were arrested. Cripps Mission. On 22nd March 1942, the British government sent a mission under Cabinet Minister Sir Stafford Cripps as the Japanese knocked on the doors of India. The negotiations between the Cripps mission and the Congress failed as Britain was not willing to transfer the effective power immediately. The Cripps mission offered grant of dominion status after the war. Indian prince could sign a separate agreement with the British implying the acceptance of the demand of Pakistan. British control of defense during the war. Both the Congress and Muslim League rejected the proposal. Gandhi called the proposals as a post-dated check on the crashing bank. Do or die called by Gandhi. The outcome of the Cripps mission caused considerable disappointment. Popular discontent was intensified by wartime shortages and steep rise in prices. The All India Congress Committee that met at Bombay on 8th August 1942 passed the famous Quit India resolution demanding an immediate end to British rule in India. Gandhi gave a call to do or die. Gandhi said, "We shall either free India or die in the attempt. We shall not live to see the perpetuations of our slavery." A non-violent mass struggle under Gandhi was to be launched, but early next morning on 9th August 1942, Gandhi and the entire Congress leadership was arrested. Role of socialists. With Gandhi and other prominent leaders of the Congress in jail, the socialists provided the leadership for the movement. Jayaprakash Narayan and Ramnath Mishra escaped from prison and organized an underground movement. Women activists like Arna Asaf Ali played a heroic role. Usha Mehta established Congress Radio Underground, which successfully functioned till November 1942. British used all its might to suppress the revolt. Thousands were killed with machine guns, and in some cases, airplanes were used to throw bombs. Collective fines were imposed and collected with the utmost rigor. Gandhi commenced a 21-day fast in February 1943, which nearly threatened his life. Finally, the British government relented. Gandhi was released from jail in 1944. People's response. As news spread to different parts of India, a spontaneous protest broke out everywhere. The people protested in whatever form that they could, such as hurdles, strikes, picketings. The government suppressed it with brute force. People attacked government buildings, railway stations, telephone and telegraph lines, and all that stood as symbols of British authority. This was particularly widespread in Madras. Parallel governments were established in Sadara, Orissa, Bihar, United Provinces and Bengal. Though the movement was suppressed, it demonstrated the depth of nationalism and the readiness of the people to sacrifice for it. Nearly 7,000 people were killed and more than 60,000 jailed. Significantly, it also demonstrated the weakening of the colonial hegemony over the state apparatus. Many officials, including policemen, helped the nationalist railway engine drivers and pilots, transported bombs and other materials for the protesters. Subhas Chandra Bose and INA. Subhas Chandra Bose, who had left the Congress, was now under house arrest. He wanted to strike British hard by joining its enemies. In March 1941, he made a dramatic escape from his house in disguise and reached Afghanistan. Initially, he wanted to get the support of Soviet Union. After the Soviet Union joined the Allied powers, which included Great Britain, he went to Germany. In February 1943, he made his way to Japan on a submarine and took control of the Indian National Army. The Indian National Army Captain Lakshmi Sahal, headed it Azad Hind Fauj, had earlier been organized by Gen. Mohan Singh, with Indian prisoner of war, with the support of Japanese in Malaya and Burma. Bose reorganized it into three brigades: Gandhi Brigade, Nehru Brigade, and a woman's brigade named after Rani of Jhansi. Subhas Chandra Bose formed the provincial government of Free India in Singapore. He gave the slogan Dilli Chalo. INA was deployed as part of the Japanese forces. However, the defeat of Japan stopped the advance of INA. The airplane carrying Subhas Chandra Bose crashed, bringing to an end his crusade for freedom. The British government arrested the INA officers and put them on trial in the Red Fort. The trial became a platform for nationalist propaganda. The Congress set up a defense committee comprising Nehru, Tej Bahadur, Sapru, Bulabhai Desai and Asaf Ali. Though the INA officers were convicted, they were released due to public pressure. The INA exploits and the subsequent trial inspired the Indians. Towards freedom. Royal Indian Navy revolt. The Royal Indian Navy rating revolted at Bombay in February 1946. It soon spread to other stations involving more than 20,000 ratings. Similar strikes occurred in the Indian Air Force and the Indian Signal Corps at Jabalpur. Thus, the British hegemonic control ceased even in the armed forces. Despite the Viceroy in the war, it left the British completely weakened. British surrender in Southeast Asia to the Japanese was a big blow to imperial prestige. All the political leaders were released and the ban on Congress was lifted. Negotiating independence, Simla Conference. The Wavell Plan was announced on 14th June 1945. It provided for an interim government with an equal number of Hindus and Muslims in the Viceroy's Executive Council. All portfolios except war portfolio was to be held by Indian ministers. However, in the Simla Conference, the Congress and the Muslim League could not come to an agreement. Jinnah demanded that all the Muslim members should be from the Muslim League and they should have a veto on all important matters. In the provincial election held in early 1946, the Congress won most of the general seats and the Muslim League won most of the seats reserved for the Muslims, thus bolstering its claim. Cabinet mission. In Britain, the Labour Party had won a landslide victory and Clement Attlee became the Prime Minister. He declared that he wanted to transfer power at the earliest. He sent a cabinet mission comprising Bethick Lawrence, Sir Stafford Cripps and A.V. Lander, rejecting the demand for Pakistan. It provided for a federal government with control over defense, communications and foreign affairs. The provinces were divided into three groups wise: non-Muslim majority provinces, Muslim majority provinces in the northwest and the Muslim majority provinces in the northeast. A constituent assembly was to be elected and an interim government set up with representation for all the communities. The Congress and the Muslim League accepted the plan. However, both interpreted it differently. The Congress wanted the division of the provinces to be temporary, while the Muslim League wanted it to be a permanent arrangement. Direct Action Day called by Muslim League. difference arose between Congress and Muslim League when a farmer nominated a Muslim members. The League argued it was to be the sole representative of the Muslims and withdrew its approval. Jinnah declared 16th August 1946 as the Direct Action Day. Hurtles and demonstrations took place which soon turned into Hindu-Muslim conflict. It spread to other districts of Bengal. The districts of Noakhali was the worst affected. Gandhi left for the worst affected regions and toured them a barefoot, bringing the communal violence under control and the spreading the message of peace and non-violence. Mountbatten Plan. The interim government headed by Jawaharlal Nehru was formed in September 1946. After some hesitation, the Muslim League joined it in October 1946. Its representative, Liaquat Ali Khan, was made the finance minister. In February 1947, Clement Attlee declared that power would be transferred by June 1948. Lord Mountbatten was sent a viceroy to India with the specific task of transfer of power. On 3rd June 1947, the Mountbatten was announced it proposed. Power would be transferred on the basis of dominion status to India and Pakistan. 2. Princely status states would have to join either India or Pakistan. 3. Boundary Commission was to be set up under Radcliffe Brown and the award would be announced after the transfer of power. 4. Punjab and Bengal legislative assemblies would vote on whether they should be partitioned. Independence and partition. The Mountbatten Plan was given effect by the enactment of the Indian Independence Act on 18th July 1947 by the British Parliament. The Act abolished the sovereignty of the British Parliament over India. India was partitioned into two dominions, India and Pakistan. On 15th August 1947, India won independence. Okay guys, thank you. Our lesson came to an end. I will meet you on following videos. Bye-bye from Srinivasan. I love you all. Take care.